this is the Rubens tube, an experiment which is a demonstration of standing waves. What I will be doing is filling this tube here with gas, and along the top of the pipe here there are holes drilled in it which will allow the gas to come out. We're going to light the gas as it's coming out of these holes. We'll get flames of about the same height all the way along the pipe. Up this end I've got a speaker. The speaker is connected to a signal generator, and I'll be playing constant frequency sound waves into the pipe via that speaker. And at specific frequencies, I should get some standing waves formed in the pipe. We will see those represented by sinusoidal shapes in the flames, because the compressions and rarefactions inside the pipe caused by the standing wave will be represented by a sinusoidal shape. They will cause the flame height to alter accordingly. Now, it's important to understand that the standing wave inside the pipe is actually a longitudinal standing wave with compressions and rarefactions. But the sinusoidal shape is just a representation of what's going on in terms of the height of the flame, because of the amount of compression or the amount of expansion that is happening within the pipe. So it's not a transverse standing wave that is actually being formed within the pipe. So I'm going to fill this with gas now and light the gas at the top. See flames lit up there. Just going to let it heat up a little bit so that we get yellow tops at the tops of the flames, so that we can see the height of each flame. Okay, I'll just guess. Now I'm going to play those constant frequency sounds into the pipe and see if I can get some standing waves formed. See the flame height changing as I'm changing the frequencies. Okay, so we can see, for example, this standing wave here. We have, you always, because this end is closed, you always have a node up this end, and that means a lower flame height towards the end. We've got an antinode here where we've got larger flames, a node here where we've got a lower flame. Antinode, node, and antinode. And towards this end, because this would be the open end, which is the speaker, we should get an antinode towards that end at the standing wave. If I just guess a bit, see a better representation. There we go. Okay, so we've got another one now there. That one, and I'll just decrease the frequency. Somewhere around here would be the first one. So that's just playing constant frequency sounds into the pipe. Now I'm going to switch over to some music so we can see what happens when we have music being played into it. standing waves almost, because each chord will correspond with a number of standing waves, because a note is a standing wave, and those are being represented in the flames here. And because of the chord being a combination of notes, you may get a number of standing waves actually being represented at one time, superimposed on top of each other. Song choice, and one of the choices chosen by students in one lesson was The World's Greatest by R. Kelly, so I'm going to play that. It's actually turned out to be a fairly good piece for showing standing waves, so here we go.
I'm a country. I'm a
So that's the Rubens tube. It's a really good demonstration that standing waves is the physics of music.